And more crimes involving guns are being tried in federal court, which can mean more prison time for those convicted.
And a task force made up of federal investigators, officers from Memphis and Shelby County, and prosecutors decide which crimes merit the tougher potential punishment. And both Bill Gibbons with Operation Safe Community and U.S. Attorney Mike Dunavant consider it a deterrent that works. Gentlemen, welcome to Live at 9. Glad to have you here.
Good morning. Thank you.
So what differences have we seen there, especially when it comes to violent crimes, when it comes to murder in the Memphis area? Mr. Dunham?
Well, certainly what we have seen, and Mr. Gibbons is reporting to us that violent crime in all major categories is actually down for the second quarter in a row here in 2018. And we believe it's directly related to some of the strategies that we have for violent crime reduction, including increasing prosecutions in federal court of firearms offenses, violent crime offenses such as robbery and carjacking and other things like that.
Because as I understand it, the federal sentencing guidelines, for instance, are tougher on these sorts of crimes, correct?
That's correct. Much more significant punishment, and it is a situation where we have truth in sentencing where there is no parole in the federal system.
So if you get 15 years, you get 15 years.
You do all the time. And so what we say, and part of our strategy with Operation Safe Community, is making sure that we're targeting the most violent people in our communities with prior violent convictions who are in possession or use of a firearm. And we're removing the firearm from their hands, removing them from the community. It's making us safer.
So, Bill Gibbons, again, the emphasis being on violent offenders, escalating domestic violence offenders, or individuals who use a firearm.
Yeah.
What differences are you seeing there, and why this strategy?
Well, the encouraging thing is that violent crime is going down, and crimes involving firearms are going down as well.
Mm-hmm.
But when you look at the Operation Safe Community plan, there are a number of key parts of that plan that really focus on this challenge. One is what Mike Dunavant just talked about, and that is using the tougher federal laws to go after those individuals who make the bad choice of committing gun crimes. Number two, as part of the plan, we did strengthen our state law on felons in possession of firearms because Mike can't take every case.
Right.
We got to handle some of those cases in the state system through the DA's office, so we did strengthen the state law as well to help with that. Number three, we want to change behavior. We want people to make good choices, which is what the Fed Up Communications campaign is trying to do, trying to change behavior, make people think twice about committing gun crimes. Number three, number four, the plan calls for increasing the number of law enforcement officers in the multi-agency gang unit. We think that's important.
Mm-hmm.
And last but not least is the ramped up commitment by the Memphis Police Department to be data-driven in allocating its resources.
But Mike Dunavant, one thing I wanted to ask you, is your job about to get tougher? You know, it's been reported that 3D printers are going to be used maybe as early as this week because the information is already being downloaded on the internet, where if a person has a 3D printer, they can essentially build their own gun. No background checks. They might be able to get those type of weapons on an airplane. What do you say to this? Are you going to fight back, or what's your sense?
Certainly the Department of Justice is very concerned about this issue. We're working with our partners at the ATF and Homeland Security to make sure that, number one, we're interdicting that and trying to respond to that and investigate it. Mm-hmm. Number two, the federal law still does allow for us to deal with convicted felons and other prohibited people in possession of ammunition. So while the firearm may be changing, ammunition is not, and so we can still target those offenders who are in possession of ammunition.
Okay, real quickly, give us an example. When the task force sits down and looks at a dozen different crimes, what might make a difference? You mentioned repeat offender, I'm assuming type of crime.
Yes.
What are the factors that say this guy or woman goes to federal?
Well, we take a look at their prior conviction history, and if there's a history of violence, including domestic violence, that gets priority.
Showing that they're just doing it over and over.
That's correct. Multiple firearms gets our attention, certainly, including stolen firearms or prohibited firearms such as machine guns or short barrel shotguns. Those tend to rise to the top.
Okay.
And then any people who are using firearms to traffic narcotics or engage in other violent offenses, such as gangs and robberies.
And Bill, are you concerned about these 3D printer guns, and will that make your job harder? And what's the concern out there?
Well,
you
I heard about it this morning on the news, so I don't know much about it, but it is of some concern because there are security issues there. If you're talking about weapons that are not made of metal, you can get through security possibly with them. So it is of concern, and I know that Congress and the administration is going to be looking at this and trying to figure out what to do. But sure, it's of concern.
Technology is always changing, and you got to stay one step ahead.
Technology tends to be ahead of the law in many cases.
Yes, indeed. But we will trust you will catch up.